I'm Sadie Danko. I work for the state as a duck biologist, and today we're going to talk about duck diversity in Indiana. So just to start, ducks are really cool. There's a huge diversity in Indiana. There's about 20 different species of ducks that come through the state, and there's a couple different varieties. There's dabblers and divers. Dabblers are kind of the ones that you see often, and they tip up in the water, and you just see their tails. Divers are going to completely dive under the water. And those ones also tend to be black and white, whereas dabblers are really colorful and they eat off the top of the water, whereas divers will go all the way down to get submergent vegetation. So what I have today is a little duck ID wing board, so you can kind of get a taste for the diversity of ducks that we have in the state. So on this side, I've got a bunch of pictures of different ducks, and then on the middle, there's gonna be a matching wing for the picture. So I'm gonna tell you a little bit about the duck and then give you some time and try to decide which one you think the wing is. So I guess to start, we'll start with our most common species, and that would be the mallard. I'm sure everybody's familiar with the mallard. They're the ones that I get the most phone calls about. These guys are really cool. They are the most numerous duck species in North America, most hunted, and they are really, really adaptable. We see a lot of them in urban environments. They're learning how to live in all sorts of places, and that makes them really unique from a lot of other species. When trying to identify them, on this board, one thing to keep in mind is they are one of the largest dabblers that we have in North America. So you're going to want to look for a wing that is bigger than the others. I'm not going to give a whole lot of other tips. We'll kind of go more into the detail of the wings once you have a little bit of a chance to pick. So if you've made your selection, I'll go ahead and help you just to get the ball rolling. So this wing right here is our mallard. You can see it's a lot bigger than some of these other ones. It's actually the biggest that we have on the board. And these ones are really cool. So something that we look at when we're identifying mallard wings is we look at this part of the wing is called the secondaries. You can see each wing has those little patches, but we look at the secondaries, and if they're outlined in white with a bluish purple on the middle, that will be your mallard. There's also other things to look at, like this part and then this top part, but that gets kind of into the nitty gritty. So something really cool about the mallards, the way to tell the difference between a female and a male is the female, this wing bar, is gonna extend all the way across this set of feathers, which we call the tertials. So that wing bar extends all the way through the tertials, whereas the male, it stops right before that. So our next duck, let's do the hooded merganser. So that's this one right here. So hooded mergansers are really cool. They're a really crazy looking bird, and they'll actually nest in tree cavities, and sometimes they will take over like a wood duck nest box. So something to look at when you're trying to identify their wings is take a look at these feathers right here. They're really dark and they're long, and they've got this white stripe in the middle, and they're like these really beautiful sweeping feathers. So when you look at your board, keep that in mind and try to make a decision. All right, so the hooded merganser, if you got it, it's gonna be this one. I was tipping you off with these long, sweeping, really beautiful black feathers with the white on the middle. And just to show you these ones, the females also look pretty similar with these ones. Here's the female wing, but they don't have quite that same sweeping. So then we'll go to our other Indiana breeder, the wood duck. The wood duck is definitely one of my favorite ducks. It's the most colorful duck that we have in the state. In the summertime, they won't actually be this colorful. They kind of get this really drab appearance. And then once they get in their breeding plumage, they have all these different colors. So when identifying the wing, something really important to think about is how colorful it is. And hopefully you can see the shine on a lot of these, because a lot of them really show up when the sunlight hits them. Some other interesting things about the wood duck is that they are also a tree cavity nester. They'll typically nest in flooded timber or in wetlands near trees because they rely on tree cavities to build their nests. And something really common with them is that they will actually produce, not all, but very often they'll produce two broods in one season, meaning they'll raise a group of babies early on in the spring, and then they'll do another brood later on in the summertime. And that makes them really unique from a lot of other species. These are definitely one of my favorites. So if you've made your guess, I'll go ahead and tell you, This is our wood duck. You can see all of these different colors. There's the blue, the purple. Especially when the sunlight hits it, it really, really shines. And I'll show you, so this is actually a female wing. I don't think I have a male one out, but so this is the female wing and the way that we're able to tell. And again, all these little tips and trades, they're not all set in stone. Sometimes it's really variable and every bird's kind of different. But with this wing, typically with the males, they'll have more of a blue appearance all the way through the wing. With this one, you can kind of see a little bit of a purple coming out right here. The main two things to look out for though, is this part of the secondary feather. See, it kind of looks like teardrops. It's like these really big, fat, white, almost like rounded parts right here. The male, it'll be really, really thin line, and it'll be almost straight line right at the bottom. But the thing that we are told to look out for the most, that's generally more true for all birds, is this wing, this feather right here. It's right next to the secondaries. I don't know if you can see it. But this feather right here is called the oil spill feather because it looks like it's got oil spilled on it, and it's got black in it. If it didn't have black in it, then it would be a male. Only the females will have a significant amount of black in it. So there's our wood duck. All right, and next let's go for the bufflehead. So here's our bufflehead. He's a really cool duck. He's really, really small. He's our smallest diving duck that we have. And he also, like the last two, will also nest in cavities. But he will breed way far north. They do not breed in Indiana. They like the kind of boreal coniferous forests next to ponds or big lakes. These are divers, so they will dive down for vegetation and they like deeper water. So these guys are also often confused with the hooded merganser, which we talked about before, because from a distance, sometimes all you can see is that white patch on the head and then the black around it. But something to look out for is these guys, you can still see, even if you're really far away, you can still see all that white right there. And they're also really small, but sometimes you can't really tell when they're right next to each other and they're really far away. But he'll have that brown. The hooded merganser will have the brown, and the bufflehead will have all this white right here. So, going to the board, something to keep in mind, this is the smallest diver that we have. So look for a small wing, and it's black and white only. So I think there's really only one that fits in that category. So that'll be this one. And so here's the female bufflehead, just for comparison. You can see it's also really tiny, black and white, but it doesn't have quite as much of that white. And you can tell that when you actually see the species itself, the bufflehead, like you can see here, he's got this huge white patch, because that's a male. The female sort of just has this little eye spot. And she's a little bit, kind of a grayish, whereas he's a really striking black, almost iridescent. Okay, so next we're going to do the gadwall. So the gadwall is a really cool bird. They are almost as big as the mallard. They're also a pretty big dobbler. And they've got this really cool patterning in them. They've got this really black tail. So if you're trying to identify them from a distance, look out for that black tail, and you'll also be able to see a little white patch. It's not visible in this photo, but it would rest about right here. There'll be this white patch right here. And they've also got this orange sort of in their wings. So that's something to keep in mind when you're trying to identify the wing. So if you're ready, you can look at the board and take a look. So look for that white, black, and orange, almost as big as a mallard. It's going to be this one. And just to show you some of the differences, so this is the female. You don't see that orange. That's kind of typical for females in general for duck species. They're a lot more drab in appearance. They don't have quite as much of that color. And a lot of times they're really hard to tell species to species differences, especially from a distance. So there's the female. Just as another example, this is actually an immature male. So the way that we decide adult, immature literally just means that it's within its first year. It becomes an adult when it's over a year old. So this immature wing, you can see it kind of looks like an adult. It's got these really nice sweeping tertial feathers, but it's just got a little bit of that orange. And that's not true for every single one, but this is just a really good example of what the majority kind of looks like. And then in general, with immature wings, they're kind of rattier looking. Like once they start to replace their feathers, they get really nice. But before they start to replace them, their feathers will look a little bit more worn than an adult. So next, let's go and do the teal. So let's start with the blue-winged teal. So the blue-winged teal is one of the first migrators. So once migration season starts happening in the fall, they'll be one of the first ones to come by. They start coming in right about the time that wood ducks start leaving from their summertime. And teal in general, we've got green-winged teal and blue-winged teal. They are the smallest dabblers. So you're going to look for a really small wing. Also note the name. The name is blue-winged teal. So I'll give you just a little bit of time to decide that one. So that's actually this one, which I'm assuming most of you got that. These ones are really cool. They've got this sort of green right under, the male does, and I actually have the female wing right above it. As I mentioned before, females are a little bit more drab, so you're not going to see that striking green. They'll have a little bit of a tinge in it, but not quite as much. And one thing I want to point out, I don't have this one up there, but I have this right here is a northern shoveler. It's a different bird. It's got a really big bill, and that's kind of a really good way to tell. They kind of look a lot like mallards, but they've got these really, really, really long bills that you can see from a distance. But if you see, they are almost identical to the blue-winged teal wings, but the only difference really is the size. And they've got these sort of really white shafted part of the feathers, whereas these guys don't. All right, so now let's continue with our teal. So then we've got the green wing. So now that we have fewer on the board, it's a little bit easier. These ones are also aptly named green wing teal, so you're gonna look out for some green. You're also gonna look for a really small size. So if you look at the board, I'll just give you a few seconds for this one. But it's gonna be this one. Something that's really cool about teal species is that they are some of the longest migrating birds. They're super tiny. I mean, they have these tiny little wings. They travel definitely the most out of all the other ducks. We've just got two left. We've got our pintail and our canvasback. So I'll tell you a little bit about both, and then we'll decide. So the pintail is a dabbler, like we talked about before, and the canvasback is a diver. Canvasback is right here, but it can often be confused with a redhead. They've got this sort of similar, I also have a photo of a redhead right here. But they look really similar, especially from a distance. They've got these red heads and sort of like a black neck and then a kind of grayish body. But the difference is these canvasbacks, you can kind of see it in this photo, but they've got a really sloped forehead. Whereas the redhead has kind of like a really steep forehead. Like he has a really defined head shape. And redheads in general kind of have a bluish tint to their bill. But another thing, like if you're at a really long distance, look for that head shape, tapered slope for the canvasback. And also their whole back body is going to be white. And that is really, you can really see that from a distance versus the redhead. So, keeping that in mind, they're mostly one color on their body. So if you want to look at the board and try to decide, with the two we have left, one that's more of a uniform color. So that's going to be this one. And another thing that's tricky is that when we're just looking at the wings, canvasback wings and redhead wings are almost identical. In size, color, they're really, really hard to tell, especially when you try to decide sex and age. It gets really tricky with those ones. So then the last one we have left is the pintail. These are a really beautiful bird. They've got this really sharp sprigged tail that both the male and the female will have. And he's just got this really beautiful markings. He's got the white part coming up his neck. And they're a really, really fun bird to see. You can kind of see the back right here. He's got those feathers that kind of remind me of the hooded merganser ones, where they're really kind of long, sweeping, and they've got this nice black and gray contrast to them. Pintails are really cool birds. They're actually really, really common in California. So that's the wing board. Thanks for playing. And just some last little things that I want to talk about that I think are really cool. I've got some other wings that I was just going to show briefly. So I was going to show you this mallard wing in comparison with the black duck. So black ducks, we have those here. I don't have them on my board, but they look almost identical to female mallards. But in general, they have a much darker appearance. You can see this is kind of like a dark chocolatey brown, whereas this is kind of a gray. And the one thing that we look for is the overall color, but they don't have any of that white
in the secondaries, whereas the mallards will have white on the top and the bottom. They're kind of like the mallard of the east part of the North America. And a lot of times people think, well, there's a lot of speculation as to these birds breeding together, which does happen. Sometimes you'll see hybrids. You'll kind of see like a black duck, but it'll look like it has kind of a green head. And that could be a hybrid. But another big thing is breeding with domestic birds. A lot of people have domestic waterfowl, domestic ducks for eggs. These can breed with wild ducks. Sort of a discussion in the waterfowl world because it dilutes the genetic integrity, basically, of the species and makes them a little bit more domesticated in general. So it's really interesting research, but these are the two differences. The other cool thing about black ducks is that the males and the females are identical, and that's really unique in the waterfowl world. I had mentioned before that they're sexually dimorphic. These guys look exactly the same. So that's pretty much it. I hope you all learned a lot. Thanks so much for playing.